JR 1 and DR 1 would be the only ones affected. Because they were going to continue on from Northport to Ripley or from Martinsville.
I mean, I don't think you take those out of them, or just kind of maybe do an addendum to the report indicating that these alternatives were no longer valid due to change of circumstance or something like that. But, that's the way I see it. I'm just doing it like that.
Well, I think the result will be that when you take away your sales in Holton, that there won't be enough water demand there, even if you're serving both Osgood and Napoleon, to take a walk across there. Right. I think the water rate would be so high that nobody would be able to pay it. I think that would be the outcome.
How long the contracts do you sign?
Napoleon signed 20.
I say it's typical.
Financing for Osgood would be 40-year financing, but the contract they signed with Napoleon was 20. I'm sure that Hoosier Hills is going to want a 40-year contract with Versailles and Holton, because they're looking at RD money too, or RD grants.
I'm not certain. It sounds like that might be a moving number and maybe not completely consistent.
I know they want at least a 20-year commitment because they need to make sure that they have the finances to repay the loan, but I'm not sure they make them go for 4 years.
I thought it was always 40, but I've heard a couple of instances where it hasn't been, so maybe it depends upon your circumstances.
Is there anything that you'd like to add to what's occurred since that meeting and your memo that sent around to them?
I guess you're going to get in a little while to the Jennings County part.
I have a whole list of things on milestones.
I'll let you tackle that. But that's it. The synopsis, I think, was pretty accurate. Everybody appreciated getting together and meeting each other. You were there, Ron, weren't you?
Yeah.
What were your thoughts? I mean,
well, I think there was enough information brought out that, you know, at least we got a feeling of all the sides of there, what they was doing or planning to do. So at least we got some definite answers that we can't get from everybody else necessarily.
I think some of them had never met each other before, so that was positive in itself, just to get the people in the same room.
Who else was there?
Really everybody but Versailles, and they were in Versailles. So, you had Napoleon, you had Holton, you had North Vernon, you had Osgood. Probably the right person to have there because he was, seemed to be very knowledgeable about the Northern system and history. Obviously, he had some history behind it, too.
Yeah, Mike's been there a long time. Yeah. He hasn't been a superintendent, but he's been there a long time. He grew up there, so he's
familiar with the
system. Mike Marshall was not there. His brother down in the utility.
Bob Reiners was there. Ron was there. Was Ray there?
No. No, it was just one from each person from each entity, so to speak. Ray was supposed to go, and that was his last council.
Oh, that's right.
It may have planted some seeds. I you know, I kind of tend to agree with you, Dan, that I don't want to take out anything that was in the report that's been approved at the Illinois Public Funding Agency, because at some point that may be gone back to and taken a look at, and there may be some valuable information for some long-term action or option.
Well, I think it also looks, I think it looks good as we looked at a lot of options and we developed some options. And to be quite honest with you, I think we didn't even argue the fact that because we brought those things to light, there are now contracts with Hoosier Hills. I think that in some way, Fargo would kind of help them to work through and find solutions. And then they found their own, which was fine, which is. We, I mean, as far as Fargo is concerned, we don't really care as long as people are making the needs of that. And I think kind of around that way we have participated in that. At least that's what happened.
I think that's pretty accurate because when we were there, the 10 council members seemed to indicate that everything was hunky dory and they didn't need anything for their water system. But it wasn't long after that that they were talking to us people. Find a way to get better order.
And if nothing else, we have a good database that shows what the infrastructure system is like in this regional area. And I think that helps for maybe looking into the future and what kind of thing needs to be done for future economic development aspect of the area. We have some good data.
Said that Osgood was going to increase their capacity to 1.5 million gallons a day from 1 million.
I believe that's right. I don't have that in front of me, but I believe that's right.
I thought that you said that.
And they're kind of doing their own thing. Osgood.
They're increasing the size of the reservoir. And they're doing a new plant project.
They're working on a new plant. And that where they're upgrading, that's what they're
doing. They're upgrading some parts and adding some parts.
They're redoing. It's a pretty major.
Their Clearwell is a significant storage thing. I believe that's new. I don't believe that one before. Now enabling to produce more water. Well, because we don't have everything in mind for what's going to come to us, I thought I'd scribble down the things that I know about that we ought to be considering for the future and try to lay out some timelines for getting it accomplished. So this is in no particular order, but it's some of the things that I believe that we need to do. And so I thought maybe we could talk about it and you could all together put them in some kind of time sequence that would be best. And maybe try to put target dates on. Thank you.
look into that now. So
I'm sorry, Dan.
Their quarry, alternative. They've established a committee now to look into that. So I think like this third item probably will not be able to ascertain until that study committee is feeling if they find that they can, it's feasible to utilize the quarry for initial supply or cost at a reasonable amount. I would probably go that way. So I don't know if we went to them now, whether they can even answer if they're willing to participate in JMRs.
Well, they indicated that, depending on the cost, that they would be interested in talking about quarters around Eastern Bartholomew or from the well field. They talked about that at night.
Right. But what I'm saying is if they, since they established the study committee, I don't know that they can't be able to answer that until they determine if those costs are too expensive or if it's not feasible.
But my thought about that meeting would be that maybe we should talk to them and ask them if they have interest in that project or how strong their interest might be. Before we went to Eastern Bartholomew, you'd ask Eastern Bartholomew what the rate might be. I don't know which one comes first. If there's not going to be any demand, then should we ask Eastern Bartholomew what the rate ought to be? Or should we go to Eastern Bartholomew first and then to North Vernon and say, this is what tentatively it might cost you, or this is the projected cost?
I don't think we need to go to Eastern Bartholomew yet, because I think they felt like they were strong for the last time, regard to Williamsburg and so forth. So I have a feeling that they wouldn't want to do that at this point. I guess my opinion is that until North Vernon completes their study group on this, they might say, well, we'll be interested in looking at that, but I don't think they will make any time. They may come up and say, okay, we know that this is feasible. Say, they may come up and say, well, it's not feasible at all. Or they may come and say it is feasible, but this is what the cost is going to be. Then I think they would be interested in saying, okay, let's look at what the alternatives are. And then we could go in to the Bartholomew and say, what's the cost going to be? And put that figure together and take that to Bartholomew and say, look, here's what this option is going to buy, whether it's Eastern Bartholomew or it's Reddington, whatever you decide. For both, I guess we kind of get into a situation if it ends up being that essentially North Vernon is the only customer of Vernon Fork Water District, and what they need us for.
That's true.
They can go negotiate with Eastern Bartholomew and Redline, or they can build wells with them, right? The only thing that we could offer, what we were looking at originally was the fact that we were kind of conduit to be able to deliver service to several customers. If it comes down to there's just one, maybe we're just going to be funding source.